With highs in the mid to upper 80s and dew points in the mid 70s, the heat index this afternoon hit 97, making this the stickiest day since the 4th of July. Not feeling like the first day of school at all, but tomorrow will feel like the second day of school. Much cooler weather is going to move back into northeast Wisconsin as we wrap up the work week and head into the weekend. Right now, we are looking at mainly lower to mid 80s, including a reading of 84 degrees in Fond du Lac and 85 in Wapaka. Sun and clouds are mixing together in the valley. The temperature is in the mid 80s. And in Green Bay, we've got mostly cloudy skies. The temperature is 83, but the dew point is 74. And when you combine the heat with the humidity, you get the heat index. Heat index values have dropped considerably from what we had earlier today, but it still feels like 90 degrees right now in Oshkosh. That heat and humidity helping to kick off some scattered showers and thunderstorms across the area throughout the afternoon. Some of the thunderstorms have been producing torrential downpours with rainfall rates of 4 to 5 inches per hour. That activity is now beginning to lift off towards the north. So we're going to turn our attention to this huge area of heavy rain and thunderstorms now coming together across northwestern Wisconsin, Minnesota, and Iowa. Some of the thunderstorms have been severe. We do have a tornado watch here for west central Wisconsin back into north central Iowa, and it does appear that the best chance for widespread severe weather is going to be to our west throughout the evening and overnight hours, but we could see a strong to severe thunderstorm push into the area later on tonight. The main threat is going to be rain, however. Flooding rain potentially, and that's why we have flash flood watches up for areas north and west of the Fox Valley for tonight into tomorrow. Once again, it does appear that the heaviest area of rain will be to our north and west from west central Wisconsin up into the central UP, but it is going to kind of give the northern and northwestern part of the viewing area a glancing blow later on tonight into tomorrow morning. Elsewhere, it looks like more scattered showers and thunderstorms. Of course, any thunderstorms that do develop could still produce very heavy rain. Amounts will vary from not much in some areas to perhaps an inch to an inch and a half in other areas. Now, where we do have that flash flood watch up, we're looking at a widespread 1 to 3 inches, mainly to the north and west of Fox Valley. Some locally higher amounts are possible if that heavy band of rain does shift just a little bit farther to the east. You can see it here on the high-res future radar, moving into central and northern Wisconsin by 11 o'clock. It then works off towards the east as we head into the early morning hours, but then the heaviest batch of rain lifts off towards the north into the UP. Now, it's not all bad news. This is an area that is under abnormally dry conditions, as you can see here on the U.S. drought monitor. So we need some rain. We just don't want too much rain. The reason for the showers and thunderstorms is a cold front that'll move through here later on tonight into tomorrow morning. Ahead of it today, we had 80s and 90s. Behind it, temps were only in the 70s. And that's what we're going to see as we head into tomorrow. It's going to feel almost 25 degrees cooler than what we had today. So tonight, showers and thunderstorms, some could be heavy, especially north and west of the Fox Valley. It's going to be warm and humid. Overnight lows only in the 70s. Tomorrow morning showers and thunderstorms, tapering to showers as we move into the afternoon. Look for windy and cooler conditions with highs in the lower to mid 70s. And then once that system's out of here, we can expect quiet weather for Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and Monday and Tuesday. We've got some great weather on the way. We're going to have a chance to dry out. Matt, it now looks like the remnants of Gordon will stay to our south on Saturday. So that is certainly good news.
Definitely. Cameron, you've been here a long time. You ever see a school district canceled the first day because of flooding?
I have not. Typically, we see our flooding during the summer or spring, not in the fall.
Pretty wild.
Yeah.
Thanks, Cameron. Coming up on NBC 26 at 6, a new year begins.